Okay. Wait, hold up.
Artists, storytellers, beatmakers, here's the latest news from the music production world. Native Instruments on a roll with these releases. They just released a brand new piano called Piano Colors. It's from the makers of Una Corda and Noir. So yeah, I know there are some huge fans out there. This is not just a recorded piano, it's much more, as you can tell from Native Instruments' video. Listen. This is not your normal sampled piano, it's a lot more. If you own Noir, you're familiar with the Particles engine. You'll find an updated version right here. Each of the colors you see in the background correspond to creative options up front in the controls. You've got control of two layers, noises, particles, and then the arpeggiator. Turn them on or off, or just adjust the volume. And I think the arpeggiator is where it's at. Piano Colors takes a different approach in interface and sound. Piano Colors is available now at a discount, $149 until July 28. Link is in the description. Audacity, the audio editing app, was recently in the news because of a change in its privacy policy that said it would start collecting personal data and sharing that data for law enforcement and litigation. Some are calling this a form of spyware. Following the criticism, the Muse Group, the owner of Audacity, has tried to backtrack, saying that the new privacy policy was unclear and they will only collect a very limited amount of data, including operating system version, processor type, and IP address. They're calling it a case of miscommunication, but honestly, if you are worried about it, you can block Audacity's access to the internet from your computer. The new policy will only come into play in the next version of Audacity 3.0.3. Older versions don't have network connection features, so you won't be affected. Okay, here's a brand new news segment based on your feedback. Quick tips. Here's the first quick tip. You can create a stereo widener effect easily using your DAW's stock delay plugin. Here's before and after. All I did was change the delay time for left and right slightly differently from each other. You don't want to sync to your DAW's tempo here. Put the feedback down and mix all the way up. Easy. Look out for more tips coming to the news report in future videos. Quick news from UJAM. They've been releasing some pretty cool new plugins lately, and now they've launched their summer sale. So lots of the plugins that you've been seeing in these news reports are now on sale, including Beatmaker Glory for trap and pop beats, and GrooveMate 1 as well. I highly suggest you check out Beatmaker Vice for 80s drums as well. I use it on a song I'm working on, and it makes things super easy. Link to the sale is in the video description below. One more plugin sale you shouldn't miss, Sublab, which is my go-to 808 bass plugin, is on sale for $40. Definitely worth the money, but I have a question for you. What do you use for 808 bass sounds? Do you use samples, a plug-in instrument, a synth? Let me know in the comments below. The Korg ModWave has been making its rounds in the reviews lately, and now you can pre-order it using the link below. The ModWave features deep wave oscillators, filters, and the Korg Chaos XY pad and motion sequencing. I love to see the Chaos pad making an appearance on an affordable Korg synth. AI, or is it III? Just released the TMA2 Studio XE headphones. These are the more budget-friendly version of their studio headphones. They also make a DJ version with some punchier bass. The TMA2 headphones are modular, which means you can switch out the parts or have additional parts depending on what you need. The Studio XE headphones are selling right now now for $180. And guess what? I've got them here. Stay tuned for the first look later in this video.
Every now and then, Eastern culture and music is appreciated and shared in such a beautiful way around the world. Our next artist and Sanjay C were just as inspired when Native Instruments released the East Asia Collection. Using the collection, our featured artist has made beautiful music. Meet Spark. Spark is from Malaysia. His favorite gear is the Novation Launch Key Mini that he says he was able to get thanks to Sanjay C's channel and the videos. And his favorite plugin is Arturia Pigments. Follow Spark on Instagram, and if you'd like your music featured on Sanjay C News, follow and tag Sanjay C, hashtag Sanjay C News, and thank you always for watching. Keep sharing your music.
It's first look time.
By the way, we haven't done first look in a long time.
Well, we haven't got new gear in a while. It's mostly plugins and stuff. There's a sticker.
I know, it's like I heart, or either an IV,
it's
IV,
not IV. It's heart. It's
what is it?
AI.
Oh.
Ivy, get to. All right.
More headphones. Wait, this is more exciting.
Earth Sounds.
My name means Earth.
Earth Sounds. Wow. Okay. They sent me these headphones to try out, and I'm really excited because I read about these and they've been endorsed by like these big producers and stuff.
Really?
Yeah.
It's like I'm about to unwrap some Nike or Calvin Klein like underwear.
This is the TMA2 Studio headphones. So yeah, you usually open the box and you expect to just pull out the headphones and there you go. What's special about these is that they're modular, meaning all the different parts of the headphones can be switched out. You can pick and choose what you want. I like this.
Wait, is this expensive?
This is the studio version, 200 and something, but they have different ones. And they just released a new one that's a budget studio headphone for $180. Okay, here's the band part. And if you can see, the band part just has the connectors so that you can connect to the speaker part.
It actually feels really good.
This is the speaker part, and those are the ear cushion part. Wow, they actually feel good.
I feel like I'm playing with Legos, but with headphones.
Think we've got them right.
Damn!
Okay. Wait, hold up.
This just like immediately gave me a burst of like adrenaline.
So the isolation is pretty good because I have it on almost full volume and I can't hear much coming out of them.
They feel really comfortable.
Okay.
Like really comfortable. And I'm wearing earrings too.
They're very snug, but not tight. Ooh, the bass is very nice.
Yeah, actually, that's one of the first things I noticed.
I feel that you can hear the highs, you can hear the mids, and you can hear the bass. They've got a pretty even volume. It's not just a lot of bass and a lot of treble and no mids. You've got everything coming through. I love that they're modular. I can replace the pads.
Okay,
I can,
wait, but what are you gonna replace it with? Like they have different colors, different things.
That's a good question. I don't think they have a lot of different colors, but wouldn't it be cool to have different color ear things?
Yeah, that'd be so awesome.
Because
you've got the matte thing going on.
Wow, they gotta do that. Okay, so you can choose a neutral sound. You can choose a punchy sound if you want more bass. You can get something with detailed sound. Very cool.
Okay, from a business point of view, this is really smart.
I think it is really smart,
I mean, because everyone's ears are different. Everyone likes listening in different ways. They have different things they want to focus on when creating music or just listening to music.
I want to do an in-depth listen to these and try them for mixing. And so you'll hear more about that. But upon first listen, you're happy with them?
I haven't been excited in such a long time. Like seeing something just innovative, cool, with so many different options. And I really think you should do the color thing.
What came with the dog?
All right, here's the freebie of the week. Thanks to Fraser M for this suggestion. Analog Obsession has a bunch of plugins, including FET compressors, EQs, LA-2A style compressors, and more. Great remakes of some classic hardware gear. I'll put a link to the plugins in the video description, and if you like them, please support him on Patreon. Great to see people creating quality plugins like these. I've already downloaded some, using them, and loving them. All right, that's it for the news. Keep making the music you love, and I'll see you again real soon. Hey, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button, and if you're looking for more freebies and news, check out my past news reports right here.